Hey, back in November previous year, I have decided to purchase a new MacBook Pro, and this time I didn't want to select the most affordable option. Yet I opted for a mid-ranger, the M3 Pro version, with 512 gigs of storage and 18 gigs of memory. In my original unboxing and review video, I've put it against my old MacBook Air from 2020 with M1 processor. If you didn't have a chance to see it, maybe it's time to check it out. That old laptop is now gone since I've sold it 2 months ago, which proves that I've been happy with the machine so far. But let's go into details. Was this purchase really worth, and are there any regrets? Before that, a question. Which laptop do you use? Please answer in the comment section below. Hi friends, and welcome to Digital Markings. I'm the channel's host Marco, and this is your dose of latest Apple news, leaked information, tech rumors and product reviews. Make sure you subscribe, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. This one is powered by Benks. I've had an opportunity to test many of their products so far, including Infinity iPad Pro Stand, Urban Pro Case with a keyboard and a trackpad, my personal favorite Infinity Mac Stand for laptops, as well as the most recent one 3-in-1 options like super high quality Infinity Omni, foldable juice pod 3-in-1, and their budget friendly on-go wireless charger. Benks products feature great build quality and innovative design. Check out the links in the description and in a pinned comment. Use Digital Markings 15 code and get 15% off. Now let's go. One thing that didn't change is the fact that MacBook Pro is still considerably heavier than my old MacBook Air used to be. Even if it's 14-inch model and not the bigger version, it's still not as comfy to carry this device. I can only imagine how it would be to drag around that 16-inch monster. Don't get me wrong, this laptop feels great in hands, and you can appreciate the quality of its construction and its design. Frankly, at first, I wasn't very keen on this new space black color, but as time is passing by, I feel more attached to it. Now, here comes an important information. I've seen that few people notice that layer of color begins to scratch and fall off easily with intensive use. I can assure you that that didn't happen to me, and I am carrying my MacBook all over the place, literally every day, coffee shops, business trips, and even vacations outside of the country. Not a single mark or scratch. When we talk about performance, I'm rocking it all the time. I've been using it intensively around 12 hours per day, sometimes for basic office tasks, on weekends working on my YouTube projects like this one, and I have nothing to complain about. Unfortunately, there is one thing that you should not be surprised. Even with 18 gigs of memory, I still deal with memory warning and the use of swap drive. Even if I'm just surfing the web with Pages, Excel, and two additional browsers open. At first, I was surprised to see this message, since the same issue used to follow me while I was using MacBook Air with 8 gigs of memory. Obviously, there are advantages of having more RAM, unified system memory as Apple likes to call it, but don't be fooled by thinking it will be sufficient. It will not. Lately, I've been trying to be merciful toward my storage, especially since now that I'm making 4K content with size of my files much bigger than it used to be. When I do a review, source material gets copied to my external SSD, and once I prepare everything and I eliminate huge extras, I export much smaller file to work with. Speaking about 4K, Final Cut is dealing with 4K content much better on this machine than on M1 Air, so no point to deny that. Believe it or not, I didn't try to check would there be an exporting issue with the screen recording on as it was in my previous video. Sincerely, I don't care as much. This animal works great. The display and the speakers of 2023 MacBook Pro have been outstanding from day one, and after 3 months I have nothing to say which will suggest otherwise. This is a multimedia powerhouse, and I have been enjoying its wide range of colors, high brightness and rich sound. There are some new moments though. I've also tried gaming, and it wasn't bad at all. Recently, I've tried Cyberpunk 2077 with a crossover app, and if we exclude few visual glitches, it works pretty good. I am using default low settings with ray tracing off, and it gets around 50 to 55 frames per second as an average, which makes it perfectly playable. I mean, this is a MacBook and it's not a PC. And do you want to know what's funny? This is one of those rare moments when I can actually hear fans working because it gets hot. Normally, this thing is dead cold. Its battery life is solid so far, with up to 14 hours of energy per single charge with 15% of brightness for my daily office work. Those numbers do change dramatically when the brightness is on max though. In that case, I feel lucky if I don't lose more than 8% of battery juice per hour. For example, one day I played Cyberpunk with charging brick unplugged. It literally sucked out my battery in less than 2 hours. Frankly, that's no big deal, especially since this is not a native game for Mac. Not to mention that macOS is still not considered as a gaming platform, nor many of its users care about it as much. So, are there any regrets in purchasing this laptop so far? As you can imagine, not at all. It worth every euro I paid for it, and I really enjoy using it. At one point, I was considering to take it back and to keep my old MacBook Air. But I didn't, and I'm glad for the sake of my work and for this YouTube channel. In many ways, M1 MacBook Air was more than sufficient, and I would still recommend that laptop or its successor with all new design above everything else for majority of people. This MacBook Pro on the other end is the mid-range option for demanding business professionals, some graphics and video creators, multimedia enthusiasts, as well as other customers who want a powerful laptop in the long run with great performance, excellent display, and amazing sound quality. That is my experience with M3 Pro MacBook Pro. If there are any changes, I will keep you updated. Therefore, please subscribe, slap the thumbs up, and turn on all notifications. My name is Marco. Have an excellent day. Bye.